DJ Esco.
There you go. There you go. Make it a little bit louder.
What I would say, type of thing, when he's playing the commercial music, I would say block that. Block that like this. Why he's going to make it.
How would you allow you keys to?
Some, but you just lost one. You might win some.
Got another minute.
babies. Mwah.
When she comes outside, she represents us. And when she
You're listening to SWB Radio every first and third Tuesday, 6 to 7. You're inside the Matrix Studios Network. www.thematrixstudiosnetwork.com.
Yo, y'all already know it's your girl, Shay Marie G. We are here at SWB Radio, Sugar Water Babies. I'm so excited. Another wonderful show. We are shooting our commercial today. So, you know, I didn't come, you know, all dressed up, but I should have wore a suit, but I didn't. I just decided to be comfortable and be myself and not give a damn. Can you say damn on FM? You can say damn. You can't say damn, right? You can say damn. Shout out to DJ Esco on the ones and twos. Hello,
DJ
brother.
Esco.
What's going on, brother? Thank you so much.
What's going on?
He's sexy. This is like my brother. I just want to like say that, you know, I love you and I follow you. And yeah, and if y'all are not going to his events, listen, he be live. But this is the thing. He's an annoying DJ. Let me tell y'all. Anybody has a DJ, like a close friend that's a DJ that'll call you at like 5 o'clock in the morning and be like, yo, where you at? And then be like videotaping you while he's this is him. 5 o'clock in the morning. He'd be like, what up, sis? I'm sleeping. That's what's up. My covers are up over my face. That's what's up. That's what's up. This is your life. Thank you. So, shout out to DJ Esco, my annoying ass brother. I love him. He's my brother. Also, I want to give a shout out to this beautiful bartender. Come here, Liz. Let's show them your outfit. Come on.
Oh my
Listen,
God.
We got the baddest bartender in the building. Hey, Liz.
Hi.
How you doing?
How y'all feel? I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing all right. You know
I'm doing. Oh my gosh, it's too much.
I'm just living my life, living my life. But thank you for coming to bartend
thank
with you,
for
with me.
I'm
a little tipsy already,
and
I got a spill. So is there napkins in here? Do you have a napkin?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, that's Liz. Look at Liz. All right. So, yeah. So, listen. So, guys, we have a packed studio, and today's show is going to be absolutely phenomenal. So, let me just go down the list of the people that we have in the building. We got Danielle Black in the building. We got Juice Cannon in the building. We got Tiffany Moore in the building. And we also have, and I'm about to introduce this beautiful, talented person, Complex Black Boy in the building, the founder and creator of Black Boy Complex. So, come to the stage. Can I get some hand claps for her? Can I get some hand claps for her? Oh, no, come this way. No. Come in.
Well,
and look, if she's smart, she brought her cup. She brought her cup.
You know.
Come, sit. Sit right here.
Right here.
All right, she's gonna sit right here. So hello, how are you?
I'm great.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well.
You're doing well?
Thanks for having me.
Good. Listen, the minute I met you and I felt your energy, I was like, yo, I gotta have you co-host the show with me.
I was drunk as fuck.
Oh, we on FM, no cursing.
And I was having a good
That'll
time.
Be $250. $250. Pay me now. Pay me now. I'm joking.
You got Cash App?
Yeah. Yes, I got Cash App. Yes.
Drunk as heck, and we're having a good time.
Yes, that was a good. What event was it that we met at?
We met at Brooklyn Boyhood's
Joy.
Well,
yeah.
It's Brooklyn Boyhood and DJ Remarkables.
Joy Day Party.
Yes. Yeah. And that was it was. And
shout
the
out
beautiful,
to them.
Just Afrocentric women that were there was just like. Phenomenal.
Right. Yeah. We had a really good time.
So please, I need you to tell me real quick, what is the Black Boy Complex? Like, what is it? Explain to me exactly the process.
All right, so Black Boy Complex is a virtual platform, soon to be physical platform, where we highlight black, masculine, or center folks, LGBTQAI, folks who just really want a place to be vulnerable, really want a place to kind of express themselves, their true selves, and really seek out the freedom that they want. So we just really try to provide a space for that. We as in me, there is nobody else in the collective.
So far, exactly.
You never know.
You got more people coming. You never know.
You know, it's opportunities are coming up. It's our very first birthday on the on October 20th, so we really got some great things in store.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, thank you. It's coming up.
Awesome. Yeah. So listen, you cool with chilling out the whole
show
with me?
Absolutely. Let's do this.
Yes. All right. So we're going to take a 2-second break. We'll be right back with Tiffany Moore. Don't go nowhere. SWB Radio Sugar Water Babies.
It's lit.
Cheers, sister.
Oh, hey.
There you go. There you go. Good intro. Give me a tissue because I spilled something.
Look.
Studios SWB Radio. I'm joined by the beautiful and talented Tiffany Moore.
Hello, how are you doing?
I'm doing well. I'm so happy to have you here.
Thank you for
and a question, who did you bring with you?
Oh my gosh. Well, that's my mom. So
Hi, mother.
Yeah, she's repping me tonight.
You're so lucky to have a mom that like supports your career. It's amazing.
Thank you.
So I was reading your bio. You grew up in, correct me if I'm wrong, Patterson.
I did.
Patterson, New Jersey.
Yeah, shout out to Patterson. Much love, yeah.
Yes, are you still living in New Jersey right now?
No, I live in Queens.
You live in Queens. Yeah. I know. Was Patterson rough growing up there?
Honestly, I wouldn't know because I was so young. I moved there like at 9 years old, so I really wasn't like familiar. All I knew about Patterson was a lot of love. Like, I got a lot of love in Patterson. I knew, I learned how to love family. Like, it was like a community raising me, and it was really amazing. So
awesome. Yeah. So as far as you and your music career, I know you started out singing in a choir. Was it a church choir?
Actually, I seen someone singing in the choir, and then I seen her, and once I seen her, I was like, that's what I want to do, and that was it. So I never actually got into a choir until like my teenage years, and so it took some time to like get out there, but I started solo, actually, and my friend was like, can you sing with me, and that's what broke me on my show, so
that was that. So are you genuine, like, just like a shy person, or?
I actually am.
You are?
I am.
I couldn't tell.
Naturally.
You can't tell, right?
You can't tell.
She can't do with the sequins.
Exactly. Right. Just shy people don't wear sequins.
Right. That's how I grew up.
But I know it is really hard, especially if you're a shy person and coming out with a talent. Because it's kind of like you're exposing yourself to people
hard.
Like critiquing you or whether it's, you know, anything, like whatever type of feedback, you got to just be like, okay, this is me, and this is, you know, like Erica said, this is my music. I'm sensitive about my, you know.
Right, exactly.
So what helped you get through that?
Oh, man. Honestly, my parents, my family, and love, a lot of love around, you know, coming up in the church. And then also, like, just breaking out of my shell little by little. It all didn't happen overnight. Like, seriously, like, it had to take friends, like, you know, ups and downs. You know, being good in sports at one time. Like,
what
that
kind of sports? Incurred,
you know, basketball. Basketball. Basketball actually.
What position were you?
And my brothers picked on me. I was a forward.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So I wasn't the point guard. You know, I wasn't making the moves, but I was, you know,
the backup. But you was the defense. Everybody needs somebody to be behind.
You know, it was definitely an experience, and it kind of helped my confidence. I boost my confidence as I grew up, and then like with my sister and my cousin, growing up with them, kind of boost my confidence as well, and just being myself. It's not, you know, I'm still shy, but I'm, you know, breaking out of it a little bit by little.
Sounds like you have a really good support system.
Yeah, thank God.
That's important. Yeah.
Sometimes you need that extra person to be like, you're good.
Yeah.
And you be like, oh, really? Why really? So I'm going to add that extra man. That sound good? That was good? All right, good.
Exactly.
So what type of music did you start out singing? Like, was it R&B or was it?
It was gospel. It definitely was gospel. And then it grew into R&B and hip hop when I was in Los Angeles. Like, I started actually songwriting, and then that's when I was like, oh, shoot, like, this could be something right here. And so I didn't know what I was good at. I just was around the industry, like, studying and, you know, learning from everybody and doing as much as I could learning-wise. I wasn't trying to be in the limelight. I wasn't trying to be the forefront person. I just was studying because I love the craft. I love singing, and I love music. So, and then it grew to R&B and hip-hop.
Awesome. I mean, how long R&B were you in Los Angeles?
For 2 years. Ooh. Yeah, living 2 years, went to school, UCLA over there.
Awesome.
Music production. And
you say that so humbly. Like, UCLA is like a big deal. Like, that would have been the first thing that came. Hey, my name is Tiffany. I went to the U.S. You know, UCLA.
Yeah,
like,
nah. It was an experience. No, it was an experience. I'm not like that. I'm real, like, low-key, like... I'm not the type.
Yeah, I'm shy. Thank you.
No, I got you. I had this conversation with a couple of artists. Actually, I had this conversation with Swift, and they were talking about like the difference between being humble and then being cocky and then just being like, it's levels to it.
It is.
So you have to take, it's a certain type of confidence that you have to have as an artist to be able to put out a product and say, this is my work. And say, this is my work. And you know what I'm saying? Like, I know this is it. So where do you channel that energy from?
It's hard. I'm not going to lie to you because... Sometimes you gotta boost that confidence higher in some areas than others. In other areas, like personal life, you gotta like dial it back. Mm-hmm. Like personal life, you gotta be like, all right, let me turn this down a little bit, cause you know I'll be switching up sometimes. I'm gonna be honest, I'm human, but you know, like but honestly, when you're on stage and when you're doing a song and you're doing writing and you're in the studio, that's when it has to be time, like 1,000, like going, you know, but sometimes it's hard to turn that off because creativity doesn't turn off. Like I can be learning something, a song right now just by you speaking and you talking. Like I could sit here and make up something like from the dome because I just was inspired and it doesn't stop. Yeah. So you just gotta be humble enough to be like, all right, let me dial it back. You gotta chin check yourself. Like, yo, let me check myself. Like, all right, I'm sorry. All right, this is what I did. Like I'm a human, so I don't try to be perfect. No way, shape, form, or fashion.
Wow.
But yeah, that's how I do it.
Do you write all of your own music?
At the moment, yes. But I am so open. I am so
open. Pause. Did you guys say I'm open to people?
I'm open to working with co-writers and songwriters as well to work on some projects. I'm definitely down for that. I'm still growing to that. I just came out last year, so it's not like I'm still new to this. So
it's a learning process.
True to this, facts. Facts. See, for years, true to this, right?
That's the key. It's true. It's true. And I feel like you can't say only a year because there's certain things that you can learn within a year that people have been in this game for 10 years and have no idea what to do. Yeah, you know? So give yourself credit. You did the work.
You did. You, especially with the support of your family and all of the channels that you took to become the best artist that you could be now.
Yes.
Thank you.
That, to me, is showing, like, it's proof that you put in the work to become who you are in this moment. And I think that's important to kind of just be in the moment. Like, you are who you are now. You're the best that you're going to be right now.
Exactly. Sister, you had a psychic moment because I was behind you like,
thank you.
That is it. So what tracks do we have from you right now?
So you have a new track. One of the tracks is called Add It Up. That's the first one I'm going to play. And then another one is called On My Mind. On My Mind came out last year of January and Add It Up just came out. It didn't even come out yet. Oh. I didn't even release it. So this is the premiere.
Give me the synopsis. Tell us the scenery of the song.
So the scenery of Add It Up, basically it has to do with, going through life. It piggybacks off of On My Mind, meaning like I'm just trying to live my life and this is me trying to handle it the best way I could. And so as a woman, you need to add it up.
Just like that.
So, yes. So any advice that you would give to someone who is a little shy and who has a talent, whether they be a singer, a poet, a rapper, producer, anything, any advice that you would give them to help them get out of their shell?
I would definitely say don't be afraid of people picking on you for just looking within and being in your own zone. Or your sweet escape. I call it a sweet escape for me. Like being in, your closet or your room. Like don't be afraid to be that person, as well as like dig in deeper within yourself to find yourself before trying to release yourself to someone else who really don't know you. You only could know yourself by going within. So spend that time, go within, and then find, and then share what you want to share with the world.
She just sent an overflow of snaps throughout the studio, and I totally agree with you. And that's something I actually have to work on, because I'm shy, but people don't know that. But I go through fits of being in myself, and people are like, "What's wrong with you?" And I'm just like, I'm just having a moment, but I'm back.
Right.
I need to enjoy the fact that I'm having that my moment. Own self. Yes. I am shy, Liz. Do not make that face. Liz is over there like, why? I don't entiendo. I don't know. Pero no conoce nada. Ella no. I am shy. No, I am. I am in my own little way. I like to be in my own zone.
Thanks.
So listen, we're going about to play your track. Right. I need you to drop your SoundCloud, your Instagram, everything where people can find you and stalk you.
All right, so have mercy. Everybody can find me on SoundCloud, Instagram, Facebook at Tiffany Moore Music, and on Twitter it's I Am Tiffany Moore. So be sure to follow. I definitely follow back, and I definitely relate and interact. So definitely come see me.
Awesome. So listen, let's get into that Tiffany Moore track real quick. Listen, guys, 718-239-9200. If you want to call in any questions, 718-239-9200. We're going to get into this Tiffany Moore track real quick. We'll be right back. SWB Radio, Sugar with the Babies. We're going to build it. Check out. Awesome. All right, picture. I'm sorry, guys.
Add it up. I never wake up with a drag of morning. You find the time just to tell me baby. What you feel? Don't tell me, baby. I could go chill. Is it me? Is it school? Is it work? Is it home? Or the car? Hold up. What her name? Add it up. 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 Yeah. Add it up. Yeah. Add it up. Add it up. Add it up. Yeah. Add it up. Baby, but I'm back now. I never back down. I used to feel sad. I don't react now. Did we take it too far in the beginning? Tempted way beyond the limit. Add it up, add it up. Add it up, add it up. Add it up, add it up. Add it up, yeah. Add it up. Kinda drippin', baby. Love is 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 kinda drippin', baby. Add it up, add it up.
What's going on? Nice. So it's your girl, Shay Marie G here. We are back at SWB Radio. So I'm joined by the oh-so-talented
Juice Cannon.
Yeah, I like
what's
Juice
up,
Cannon.
Yeah.
So suave, Juice Cannon.
Yes, yeah. And yeah. I want to say he rides a motorcycle.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I was so, he rolled up, he was like, what up, Shay? And he has a little, like, helmet in his hand. I was like, whenever somebody has a helmet in their hand, it's like, there's no way. Like, you just popping. Like, that's it. Like, that's it. It don't matter if you're, like, a good rider. It don't matter if you drive a 200 or whatever, or 150.
I got the three. I got the
you got
like, Honda CBR 300.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Okay. A 300 what?
Well, that's just it. 300.
Oh, no, Honda a Suzuki what? Like
oh,
a...
no, Honda CBR 300.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. 100 miles.
All them numbers I don't know, but it sounds cool.
So the yeah. number is like the weight, right? Am I wrong? The weight of the actual
it's
bike.
It's the size of the engine.
Oh.
Yeah,
oh.
It's the size of the engine. Yeah, so you yeah. got...
So it's like
it
300
goes...
cc's?
Exactly.
Bomb bomb. Okay.
Okay, you know your stuff.
She
you know your
it.
Stuff.
She on it. Am I?
Yeah.
That's my good stuff. So listen, so let's talk about your career as an artist? Yeah. I know that you're very multifaceted, that you do a lot of things, and I want you to just brag on yourself real quick. I need you to just list
all the humble brag.
Yeah, do it. This is what you're here for, baby.
Okay, okay. So like 2 years ago, I did this event. I did a tape called Juice Pop, and then I did the event, and then I packed it out. Like I had like 100 people there. I did collaborate with someone else, but we brought a big crowd like that, and then that was my first show, and it like opened my eyes to know like, yo, I could do this myself, you know. Also, I did a tape last year called Sugar Water, which is ironic, you Sugar Water Babies.
When I read that, that touched my spirit, like he understands. So what is your definite, well, let me not finish your question, then I'm gonna come back with that, because I'm gonna keep it in my mind, I'm not gonna forget it.
But yeah, yeah, I'm about to go more on Sugar Water. So
yes.
for Sugar Water, what it meant for me was just like, yo, I feel like everybody was in drugs and stuff, like the young kids, and that's what they was talking about. So I just felt like, let me just come with something bizarre. And Sugar Water just felt bizarre, and it was basically like all the records that came out last year, and I remixed it.
Mm.
Yeah, yeah, and I did like 4,000 streams on that.
Wow.
Yeah,
nice.
4,000 or 5,000.
So, but as far as an artist, what do you do?
Like, you mean like the style of music I make?
Yes.
I got my own studio. Yeah, studio like, 231.
I want you to like say that. I'm like, listen, yeah. I know, but I want people to know. I'm like,
I got my own studio, Studio 231. You know, I spent a lot of money developing it. It's in my crib. I record other artists, so if any other artists want to work with me, just, you know, reach out. And
producing tracks.
Yeah, I'm trying to see what else.
Are there any particular artists you're looking for?
Doesn't matter. I'm open to work with anybody. That's how you should be. Anyway.
And that's how it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
Aww. So what kind of music are you currently working on right now?
Right now I'm pushing a single called Queen. And Queen is like is catching up, like it's getting played in Florida, it's getting played in Philly, and now I'm just trying to work it a little bit in New York.
What kind of track is it though?
Oh, Queen is just all about the queens in this room, in this world, and I just wanted to be different. I don't want to be derogatory and all that music, cause I mean that's what's out now. So it's like let me just be the oddball, you know, just try to go left.
Exactly. So I was reading on your bio that your family is from Nigeria.
Yeah.
So were you like an American Nigerian, like second generation or like?
No, I'm an American. Like I was there when I was one, came back. Then I went when I was 12. So that, you know.
So how long were you there for though?
2 years.
2 years.
Yeah, but that was like the first year and then the 12th year. So like my memory's not all that good.
Do you speak the language?
Kinda, sorta.
Kinda, aw, come on now.
Like as much as I know, it's like, good morning, like, Bawani and stuff like that.
Is there, are your parents, they don't force you?
Nah, because I think they kinda just understood, like, they brought me here young and, I don't know.
They felt like, okay, you're gonna have to adapt sooner or later, so just adapt to your environment.
Pretty much.
Really? Your parents are really nice, because all of my friends who are from Ghana, I would say, their parents was like, no, you are going to speak the language, and I don't care if you're in America or not, you're from, you know.
Yeah,
so.
Ghana's a neighbor, it's in West Africa, I'm from West Africa too.
Yeah, so, see, yeah, I know y'all cousins. Yeah,
it's like, pretty much, right there. We right there.
So you're saying your parents are perfectly fine with you, like, pretty much completely assimilating with, like, American culture?
Yeah, they don't mind. That's like my girl is American, so it's like,
oh, word.
Yeah.
And they accept her? Let's be funky. They like her?
I mean, my grandmother was the one like, oh, I want you to, you know, have a Nigerian woman and stuff, right. But everybody else is cool.
Oh, okay. But I knew it had to be some pushback. I was like, this can't be perfectly okay with this.
Nah. I think it's the older ones. The older generations are more like, oh, they want to keep it traditional. And,
yeah.
Right.
But yeah, you know.
Did that influence you at all as coming out as an artist? Like, did you have any, like, negative responses as far as, like, you and tapping into your artist?
Nah, because most people don't know till I tell them. You know? Mm. So it was just, like, I could be incognito and just, I don't know. Like,
do you like being incognito?
Yeah, because I get around other Africans and they don't know.
Oh. Okay,
yeah, gotcha. Yeah. So I know a little bit of it. So if I hear it, like, I could probably, you know.
Yeah. Well, that's good. As far as like just being an artist and being able to have a comfortable position in the background, I feel like if you're comfortable with that, then do it because you're able. Those people shoot producers in the background. People be making the most money out of everything.
Yeah, you get your money up front.
Yeah, exactly.
That's it. You get your money up front. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. And then I just had to invest in the right studio equipment too. You know, because after a while as an artist, you keep going to studios and you're just like, yo, maybe I could have just bought my own stuff. Mm-hmm. You know? So the game is just always to get to the next level, always elevate.
Exactly. Yeah. So when you built your studio, did you like literally just start from like at nothing, or like did you like, let's say, I'm gonna buy all of this stuff?
No,
like...
I mean piece by piece, you know. Okay. So first it was the speakers, the studio monitors, then it was the computer, then it was the Pro Tools, and yeah, and then I paid for a booth that cost me like $900. Yeah.
So where do you have this set up?
In my crib.
No, but like where? Like in the living room?
Oh, yeah. It's pretty much in the living room.
Yeah, but you know,
I live by myself, so it's like, yeah.
Oh, okay, so it's your own space. So it's not like you'd be like, hey, come on, put that down. It's like, I got my own space. Yeah, turn that music down, you know? Like,
right.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah, I control it.
Exactly. So what tracks, do we have any mixes or any tracks from you today?
Just Queen right now.
Queen?
But next time, I'm going to bring some stuff from Sugar Water.
Please do.
Yeah. I actually got a song, Niger Girls Got Juice, and I'm talking about Nigerian women.
Awesome. You know. See, for me, my thing with Sugar Water was like, I'm an 80s baby, so Sugar Water was something like of just like making the best of what you got. A lot of the 80s kids, their parents were either on drugs or not there, or listen, if you grew up in the 80s, you know how it was. The parents was just not all of them. I'm not gonna say all of them, but a huge percentage, because it was a huge epidemic of just alcoholism and people on the crack. Yeah. So it was just about making the best of what you got, because when you had water and you had some sugar, you had juice, you was good, like, you know.
Right.
Like literally, yeah. You know, so it's just about making the best of what you got, and that's exactly what I saw when I read your bio and just the story of your life and you just overcoming
that's
so
a dope
much.
Perspective you gave me a new perspective on the tape, because I didn't even think about it like that. Yeah. So that's dope. I appreciate that.
Yes. And then so let's just talk about you. I don't want to dive too much into your business if you're not mm-hmm. willing to share. But I know that you spent some time incarcerated and some time away from your family. How did that affect your artistry? Like, how did that affect you personally and with your music?
I mean, at that time, I wasn't serious about it. But what it did is gave me the ambition when I got out to, you know what I'm saying, like, pursue it full time. So as far as my family... my mom came, she came to visit me, and, you know, I did my time, you know? I was 6 months, I was on Rikers. But, by the way, this is like a decade ago.
Yeah.
So,
even
but
then,
it's still...
if I spent one day in jail, I'm talking about that for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
I've never been locked up. So that, what it does to you mentally, for you to have this type of freedom and then to have... that's a lot, and even though you may not see it and may not admit to it, that is a lot that was taken away from you, whether it been a day, whether it be a month, whether it be 6 months to 10 years. What it does to you as a person, it strips you.
Yeah, like my OGs told me, like, yo, that shit changes you, and he's right. Oh, my bad.
That's okay.
But like he said, it changes you, and you know, 10 years later, like, I still have it in the back of my mind, like, I'm not going back. So.
Exactly.
You know, so,
speaking of all the different life experiences you've had, including the time that you spent incarcerated, where do you feel like you pull your most inspiration from when creating
music?
Oh,
man, that's a great question. Where do I pull my most inspiration from?
Yeah.
I would say that, definitely. And I would also say just being creative. Like, it just comes. It just hits you, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it could be about love. It could be about... street stuff that I was involved in, all of that stuff, you know, and stories too. So, you know, it gives me the space to talk about authentic stories.
Exactly.
So.
Do you have periods in which you feel like certain ways? Like, I know sometimes, like, as a DJ, sometimes I have, like, I'm in a mood, and I'll just be in my mood for, like, a good month.
Oh, like, do I, like, play my own music?
Do you have certain moods in which you, in where, like, an album is about this, and this album is about that, or an EP or a mixtape?
Yeah, I would say Sugar Water. Sugar Water was a nice blend, you know? Like, Trapping in My Hand is my favorite one, you know? Yeah.
Listen, you got to come back with Sugar Water. Listen.
Yeah, I'm coming back with
that. The next time you come back with Sugar Water. So I need you to drop your SoundCloud. Where can people pay for your music? Because I know you got 4 albums. I'm just going to start talking on you.
Because
he doesn't like bragging on himself, so I'm going to just do it for you. 4 albums, like, hello.
That's a lot.
And your Instagram, your SoundCloud, and then we're going to get into that track real quick.
Okay. I'm not on SoundCloud. I know that's like a shocker.
Say because that's SoundCloud.
But my thing with SoundCloud is, I feel like as artists, like, we have a streaming platform and people will listen to your music wherever you want to put it.
Okay.
So SoundCloud is like, they're not really monetization. They're not paying us.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like I just rather go with the big boys.
Okay, so the big boys is who? So who you on with the big boys?
The three-headed monster.
Who's the three-headed monster? Apple.
Okay. Tidal.
Okay.
Spotify.
Okay, so listen.
The three-headed monster.
Listen, we not hating. You right. Get your money. Four albums, I want my money too.
Yeah, definitely.
Pay me. So listen, we're going to get into this track real quick. We'll be right back with the oh so beautiful Danielle Black. Wow. SWB Radio Sugar with the Babies. We out.
It's lit.
We'll be right back. Oh, it's
a while. When she comes outside, she represents us. And when I say us, I mean men, kings. So that's birds, pigeons. That's what we need time to time or whatever. But in the long run, you're going to be a lady. What's special about me? I mean, we all need it.
Tell me that it's lust, but I know it's love. She pulled me from the edge when push came along and shove. Haters always talking like they really know what's up. Their hearts are paper thin, they suffer from paper cuts. Peanut butter, dark chocolate, Hershey kisses. Finna make some Reese's Pieces with the missus. A queen stands out in a room full of peasants. Got me feeling like a kid in a room full of presents. Don't say you want a queen if you ain't a king yet. You just be holding the back, go through the process. I love a queen with knowledge of self. Before you step to her, know yourself. Queen.
Light skin, dark skin, all kind of color skin, the stellar skins. I heard what these guys say to you, but don't pay no mind unless they say you a beautiful queen. Light skin, dark skin, all kind of color skin, the stellar skins. I heard what these guys say to you, but don't pay no mind unless they say you a beautiful queen.
Know yourself, queen. Know yourself, queen.
I heard what these guys say to you, but don't pay no mind unless they say you a beautiful queen.
I look at you and me, and many
the building. I'm also joined by
Complex Black Boy. What's good?
Hey, what's going on? And we got the beautiful Danielle. It's a Danielle. And the black. And then a Danielle. Oh, I'm sorry.
That was amazing. That was the best introduction I've ever
had. Yes! So, what's up, beautiful? How are you?
I'm great. I mean, I'm feeling better from the other night.
Yeah, listen. So we did, SWB Radio, we hosted our first networking slash fundraiser event, and you came through, and
it was more like a glorified house party.
No! It was so much fun.
The place was so dope.
Oh my God, we had a lounge downstairs, and then we performed outside.
I found out later on, and I went downstairs, and I was like, why isn't anyone down here?
You're like, this is so nice.
Yeah. And I came down and I was just like, oh, I understand why now.
But it was so much. It was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. Someone left their teeth at the party.
No!
Yeah, like on the green table. Somebody like put their teeth on the food table and like, that's when you know it's a good party. When people leave their legs and their teeth, yo.
Who left their leg?
Listen, nobody left their leg. Nobody left their teeth, though.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
It was crazy. So we've been following your career. I think I've met you maybe, a year ago or 2 years ago, maybe. Yeah. And it's been a steady flow of just amazing. So how has it been, and how do you feel about your career now? Because before you were like, you know, like, I'm just trying to get things done, and now that a lot of things are done, like, how do you feel?
Recognized.
Yes.
I feel like I have recognition. Okay. I'm flying to different states, I'm performing everywhere, you know, I'm just building my following. So that's really what it is right now. I came out with a new EP, I did it within 4 months just to be consistent, you know what I mean? I went through a little time where I was like, I don't know what I'm going to do, I don't know, you know, if I'm going to continue with doing rap, I don't know what I'm going to do, I want to get into a little bit of dance. So this EP, we introduced trap and dance music, and we killed it.
Listen, when I first met her, we met at Brooklyn. I think it was a competition. And no, I'm
in the Bronx.
Lying.
In the Bronx.
I met you
at Essentials.
Yeah, I met you at the Bronx at Essentials. And, you know, we talked and chatted. And listen, we chatted before she performed. So when I saw her perform, she came through like, and I said, oh, okay. Like, it took me off guard. When I tell you, honest to God, and that's just me just looking at you, thinking that you're going to come with, you just came through like, bout it. Like, you came through like, hard. Like, yo, no, this girl is really a force to be reckoned with. And I feel like, do you feel the pressure? Because I know you're Italian, right? Italian and Puerto Rican. And I know when people see you, they automatically take you as a white woman.
Yes.
You know, automatically.
Yes.
So then how do you combat that? Like, your flows are sick. Let me just say that.
Thank you.
But how do you combat with the constant fighting, you know what I'm saying? I'm just like, this is who I am.
You know, everybody, all races, everyone has this racist thing. And you know what? It is what it is. If you're good at it, why should you be recognized as white? Why should you be recognized as black? Like, it is what it is. If you're good at it, you're good at it. Mm. It's never just one thing. And I think that's where people, you have to draw a line, and I have boundaries, and I'm just like, this is me, this is what I do, I like to do it. I consider myself an artist. I'm not like, oh, I'm a rapper and I'm gonna freestyle right now and I'm gonna battle rap you. Like, that's not what it's about. I have rhymes, I write my own shit, you know, sometimes I co-write with other people. Guap from Uni Music Studio, let me shout him out. you know, it is what it is. I don't think that rap is black. I don't think that dance is white. It is just what you do.
Yeah. And if you're good at it, just accept the fact that
you're good at it. You're good at it.
Yes. And you listen, and you have the stage presence.
Thank you.
You have the full, you're beautiful. And it's not that you're just beautiful, you're a beautiful person. And I feel like in your raps, it shows in your raps, because you talk about empowering women. You talk about finding who you are.
Yes.
And it definitely comes through with your music. Do you identify as a feminist at all, or?
No.
No?
Well, what's that face for?
I'm in the middle of everything. I'm a person of understanding. So I'm the person that everyone comes to solve the problem, because I hear you, I hear the other side, and then I find the truth. Mm-hmm. And it is what it is. Some people don't like it. Some people don't like to hear the truth. I'm the person that I want to hear the truth. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. Exactly. You know what I mean? And it's not about women. It's not about the man. It's not about black. It's not about white. It just, it is what it is. You have to look at the facts. And that's the end of it.
That's just what it is.
Yeah, well, I'm going to be running for president one day. Yes.
Yeah.
I will.
I find, and it seems like you seem to take a pretty neutral stance.
I do.
In between just race and gender, and since that's my thing, I wanted to ask, like, in because you're saying, in you mentioning that it is what it is. What if it is black? And what if it is woman?
In that situation.
What if it is, you know, then what do we do in those situations when channeling your rap? Because, you know, as you know, rap is, or hip hop historically is, a black male identified, just a dominated
world.
So how do you find yourself navigating through
well,
that?
Well, things evolve. And if we don't recognize things evolving and we continue looking at how things started, then we're constantly going to be going backwards. Mm-hmm. So if we don't recognize, you know what, it's not just male, it's not just black anymore, it's not just this anymore, it's now this. And we have to recognize that things evolve and things change. Mm-hmm. And back in the day, like my grandparents and my parents, like their generation, I look at them, I'm like, why don't you use a real cell phone? Like, mm-hmm. why don't you use this? Why don't you use that? And why don't you recognize that things change and evolve? And it's important for us to evolve. Technology evolves. Mm-hmm. So we have to evolve with the changes. Sometimes it's not what it used to be. It is what it is now.
Okay.
Gotcha. So it's just pretty much making your statement as who you are right now and to be accepted. But I think what she means is, like, what if you're trying to break through barriers and that acceptance is not there, that understanding is not there. Like, where, you know,
well, I was there in the beginning. I didn't feel that I was accepted. You know, I could have won those awards a million times over, kept telling, I was, you know, when we were at Essentials, I was kept telling, oh, you're gonna win. And then all of a sudden I wasn't winning. So I was like, all right, well, I am better than this. And, you know, maybe it is because I'm white. I don't know. I don't know what it is. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But it's, for me, I just accept the fact that it is what it is, you know? And I've already been recognized that I am a great artist and I can rap and I can do this. And you know what? I'm succeeding farther than all of those people that are there and that have won those awards. And I don't need to win that award because I'm winning.
And talk about my sister like she's not popping.
Yeah, to me, they're winning those awards, but to me, I'm winning in real life. Yep. So there's a difference. And that's how I look at it.
I think authenticity is really important here, regardless of where you are.
And that's one thing I can honestly say. You have been authentic from the very beginning. And I see you going, girl, listen, when I saw you, was like, yeah, I'm doing a Tori Kelly. I was like, and like, I really feel you, and I feel who you are as a person. And you know, I definitely admire you. You already know that. I will follow you to the sky. And also, shout out to the hubby in the building. Shout out to the hubby in the building.
Shout out to Guava Uni Music Studio. You already know where to record.
Yes.
White Plains.
He's so dope and he's so supportive. And I told you on Friday, I was just like, I'm standing behind him and I'm like, yo, I'm having this guy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he, and you surround yourself with positive people. And I think that that's the key to being successful.
Yes.
Surround yourself by people who are going to support you and who are going to, you know what I'm saying?
Keep it real with you.
I agree.
Keep it funky. So listen, we are running out of time and I apologize.
It's okay.
But we have Trap Madonna.
Yes.
And I want to play Trap Madonna. And please give me the synopsis of Trap Madonna.
Oh my God, me and Guap were in the car and we were listening to beats because half the time, I mean, we're just constantly creating. It never ends. It's a little annoying sometimes, but it's okay. It's just how the business is. Anyway, so we're in the car and we're listening to the beat and he's like, Vogue around the Trap Madonna. And he's like, wait, play the beat back. I'm like, oh my God, well, I just had to stop at a stop sign. And he's like, let me get my voice memo. And he's like, Vogue around the Trap Madonna. And he's like, you're the Trap Madonna. You live in Westchester Hills. Trap Madonna from Westchester Hills. And I'm like, oh my God. And that's all in the hills in the Trap Madonna. So it was really funny. And it winded up becoming a song and the hook and
And I love that song.
From there.
I'm interested and in hearing that. I wanted to hear, what song did I like? What is the song that I
You love Flex.
Flex, yes.
Yes.
Listen,
yes.
I'm person, if I hear a song and it's popping, that's the only song I want to hear from you. And I'm one of those people that you go to concerts and the artists have to sing the same song over. I'm those people because I'm like, play the song that you recorded in like 2000. You remember that one? But I'm one of those people. And you're like, no. Trap Madonna is popping. And he was like, no. And I'm like, no, I want to hear Flex. He's like, no. Trap Madonna. And I'm like, whatever. And then when you said, I was like,
you came up to me and you were like, so wait, you're going to play Flex? I was like, no. Yes, that was like last year. Like, but it's on the EP. Yeah,
but that song was so popping. So listen, we're about to get into Trap Madonna. Okay? Listen, guys, drop your SoundCloud. Play that Trap Madonna. Play us over the beat. SWB Radio. You can go into that Trap Madonna real quick. Listen, that's Danielle Black right there. Drop it.
AddressDanielle.music. This is Trap Madonna.
Hey. SWB Radio Sugar with a Baby. Thank you guys for listening.
I love you.
Trap Madonna.
Is dripping like a virgin hit for the first time. Everybody's got the drip, they sniffing on the first line. Everybody's wondering how I cross the borderline. All these haters wanna talk, but they only talk online. Everyone's an opportunist, all these suckers on mine. They never seen a look so fine. The way I shine will blow your mind. Self-made, self-employed, they still trying to be a boss. I cook up that marinara and they still trying to find the source. Thank you.